One of the limitations of large meetings is that not everyone gets a chance to speak up and be heard, which understandably hinders the meaningful collaboration and engagement of meeting participants. If you're looking for ways to overcome this trap in your online meetings, you're in good hands because today we're putting all of our focus on breakout rooms. Hey guys, I'm Daniela, content manager at Livestorm, the browser-based video platform for managing all of your online meetings and events in one place. In this video, I'm going to share what breakout rooms are, how they work, and I'll provide you with real examples of what it looks like using Livestorm. I'll cover the more practical stuff, like how you can create them, how participants can be assigned, and tips for getting the most out of this feature. Are you ready to dive in? Let's go. In simple terms, breakout rooms allow you to break a big meeting into smaller private sessions. And they're great for those moments where participants need to branch off to discuss, deliberate, and share ideas in smaller groups. And there are a number of use cases where breakout rooms come in handy, whether it's for online classes or training, focus groups, workshops, networking, or even speed dating. The list goes on and on. The way that virtual breakout rooms work is you first need to find a video platform that supports this functionality. With our browser-based platform at Livestorm, you can access this feature directly in the event room. When you start your event, you simply need to click on App in the sidebar and then Breakout Rooms. And you can create as many breakout rooms as you want, whether it's two groups of 10 participants or 10 groups of two. And keep in mind that in order for your breakout rooms to be most effective, sticking to 3 to 4 people within each room is ideal. I find that it's a perfect size group to give everyone a chance to engage, speak up, and be heard. There are 3 different ways to assign people to a breakout room using Livestorm. The first is autonomously, where attendees can choose for themselves which room they wish to enter. And the second is manually, where the event or meeting organizer chooses how they'd like to assign participants. And the third is automatically, which is basically random selection chosen by the platform where attendees are divided evenly across available breakout rooms. Now, if you're wondering if people can switch between rooms, the answer is always yes for team members and guest speakers. But if you'd like to enable it for everybody, all of your participants, you just need to click on this button here. Participants can switch rooms during session. Now, we already talked about the ideal number of participants for each breakout room being 3 to 4 to get the best engagement from everyone, but I have some other tips to share as well. You'll also want to set a clear agenda. There's nothing worse than getting into a breakout room where all you hear are crickets and no one knows what to do or what's going on. Avoid this by providing a clear agenda for everyone beforehand and by setting clear expectations for what should be achieved through these sessions. Providing your participants with a time limit in the breakout rooms can keep them focused and on track with the task at hand. I recommend actually including this in the agenda and mention the start and end times for the breakout room sessions. With Livestorm, you can even use our timer app in the breakout rooms to make sure that no one loses track of time. And finally, ask for feedback. The surest way to really know how you can optimize a breakout room experience is to ask participants for their feedback. And there are a few ways that you can do this. You can either ask them to share in the chat, you can set up a poll, or you can even let them share their quick feedback using fun emojis. If you prefer more detailed responses, you can also launch a call to action directly in the event room, redirecting participants to your survey. Or you can send a follow-up email straight from the platform, also linking to a survey after your meeting. All right, folks, that's it for today. I hope you have a clear idea of what breakout rooms are, their benefits and versatility, and how it works at Livestorm. I'll see you soon, and until then, keep creating, keep engaging, and keep those connections alive. I'll see you later. Take care.